Welcome to Programming with Professor Califf. Today I'd like to talk about variable declaration and assignment. So last time we talked about what variables are and the fact that they are containers, set aside pieces of memory to hold values we give names to so that we can interact with them, we can store data, refer to the data that's stored, so we can change data, keep track of what it is, and so on. But when we think about what's actually in memory, we don't have data that looks quite like this. Instead, what we really have is a bunch of ones and zeros. So one of our challenges in dealing with variables is that the computer has to know what kind of data we have, because we need to know, or the computer needs to know, is this a 90 or is it a Z? They'll have exactly the same representation when it comes to the binary. The computer determines how to interpret that data, and that tells us what we actually have. So this means that in a language like Java, we have to declare our variables. So some languages just keep track of what kind of data we put into the variable. But in Java, we are required to declare it. So what that means is that we have to say, this is the name of the variable that we want to use. Here's the type, what kind of data the variable has. And if we want to, we can also say, this is the variable's starting value. We don't have to do that, though we do need to make sure that we give the variable a value before we try to use it. So what does a declaration look like? Well, basically, we're going to have the type, what kind of data, followed by the name. What do we want to call this? We can actually declare multiple variables of the same type at the same time. So I could say this is an integer, and I want three integers with these three different names if I wanted to. If I want to specify that initial value, I'm going to have type, name, the equal sign, and then the value that I want it to have. Here are a few examples. We have a character. We read that char as either char or char. I'll tend to use char. Char is also very common. So we have a character, someone's middle initial. Int stands for integer. NumStudents, obviously supposed to be keeping track of a number of students. Float, for the moment, let's just think about those as real numbers. I'll get into what those actually are in the next video. And then we have a couple of examples here of setting that initial value. So int numLives is 3 is going to make numLives be 3 to begin with. Char grade is equal to b will make grade start out with the value b. Now, when we think about these variables, they're not very useful unless we can put data into them. So we have a special operator called the assignment operator, which looks like the equal sign, that we use to put values into variables. So we call it the assignment operator because we say it assigns a value to a variable. Now, when we think about this operator, equals is what you're inclined to call it, right? You've been calling that symbol equals for a long time. However, we need to think about what it actually means when we look at a line of code like this one. NumPizzas equals NumPizzas plus 1. Now, from all the math I know, that is an impossibility. No matter what the value of NumPizzas is, it's not the same as NumPizzas plus 1. So we want to avoid using the term equals when we see this in Java or in other languages that use this symbol for assignment. Instead, I encourage you to use a phrase like is assigned or gets. So numPizzas is assigned numPizzas plus 1, or numPizzas gets numPizzas plus 1. Then we're not setting up a mathematical impossibility, and that also helps us remember that direction matters here, because we're going to first compute the value on the right, and then we're going to assign that to the location on the left. And when we think about it that way, then num pizzas gets num pizzas plus one makes sense. We've just changed the value of num pizzas to be one more than it was. Okay, so let's try this in a program. Let me pull over VS Code. I encourage you to get your VS Code up or whatever IDE you want to use. You will not learn much from this video series at all unless you follow along and actually do these things. So we're going to go ahead and go through the process of creating a project just to make sure everybody remembers how we do that. If you're using something else, make yourself a new space to work. So I'm going to create a new project, find the place I want to put my project, and then let's call this one variable practice. And now I'm going to click here in source. Let's just edit the app that they gave us. So we're not going to throw any exceptions, actually. And this is not what I'm going to print. So we're just going to get rid of all of that. So let's start creating some variables. So I'm going to start out with numStudents gets 20, int numLives, and care grade gets B. Let's go ahead and do a little printing of these things so that we can see that they are real. So I'm going to print numStudents colon space and then system.out.println the actual value of numStudents, which I would prefer had an S on the end of it. Now this is one nice thing. Most IDEs will do this for you where they suggest possible values for things you're typing. It can be very useful. I'm gonna do a little copy paste. Modify. Always make sure you do all the modifying if you do that sort of thing. Lives. And then finally grade and grade. Okay. Let us run this. And we're going to see, oops, we have an issue. And the issue is that the local variable numLives may not have been initialized, and in fact has not been, as you can see. So we're going to come in here and give it a value. So let's make it be 3. And now if we try to run our program again, this time we'll see that numStudents is 20, numLives is 3, grade is B. I want to show you something real quickly. I'm going to make a grade be an integer. Now you notice when it's a care, we printed out B here. I'm going to run this, and you'll notice now grade prints out as 66, which happens to be the code, the actual number that gets stored for the letter B in the computer. Interestingly enough, I can put this character into the int. Characters in many ways are numbers in most computer situations. Java doesn't treat it as much like a number as some programming languages do, but certainly it allows you to do this. But because it's an int, the print here translates it, it treats it as an int. But of course, when we made it a char, then we got the letter B that we were expecting. Now I want to look at actually changing things so that here we've initialized things. We have used assignment a little bit here to initialize our num lives after we did some other things. But now I want to look at actually making changes to the data that we have. So numStudents, I'm going to make bNum students plus one, num lives. I'm going to actually subtract a life, since that's what would typically happen if we were writing a game. Though sometimes we gain lives by picking up skill ups, or, you know, picking up some sort of power up or something. And I'm going to say course is going better. We're up to an A. Now I'm going to go ahead and copy my printing. And run this. And we'll see. We have num students is 23b. Of course, this is the same printing as we had before. Then after we increased num students to num students plus one, we computed that value. We assigned it into num students. Now it's 21. Same thing happened with the A, but you'll notice that num lives was 3, and we would expect it to be 2. This is actually because I have an error here that is very common when you're copying and pasting code. Since I had the num lives is 3 in the middle of my printing, when I copied and pasted my printing, I also reset num lives to 3. So it's one of those things you always have to watch out for whenever you're copying, modifying code, that kind of thing. Make sure that you get all the changes made, that you've only got the pieces you wanted. So we'll come back here and run this again and see that in fact num lives is changed. And in this case, we haven't changed it back. So hopefully that gives you something of a taste of what assignment and variable declaration actually looks like, a little bit about what it's about. So in the next video, we're going to talk about types, things like char and int, but also float and some other possible types of variables that we might use. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you next time.